Kafakara Book 6, This Means War, by Kyed Knudsen. Narrated by Jennifer Wagstaffe. Kara, favourite colour, light blue. Favourite food, lasagna. Favourite school subject, art. Loves to read. Rose, favourite colour, pink. Favourite food, pizza. Favourite school subject, gym class. Loves to shop. Julie, favourite colour, yellow. Favourite food, tortillas. Favourite school subject, music. Loves boys. The hairdresser. Kara has just finished school for the day. The sun is bright and the birds are singing. Kara puts her winter jacket into her bike basket. Julie does the same. It is too warm outside to wear them. They are in a hurry because they've planned to play hairdressers at the after-school club today. Julie has brought a straightening iron that can make curls too. Rose cannot join them because she is not at school today. On the way to the club, the boys overtake them. "Hey, girls!" Benjamin shouts and almost runs into Kara. "Who wants to play war?" Lucas yells as he speeds past them. "Watch out!" Julie yells while her bike is reeling. "War!" Benjamin shrieks and rings his bell. "You are so childish," Julie yells. Kara looks for the boys. She kind of wants to play war. It's like role-playing with costumes and homemade weapons. The boys play war almost every day at the club. When they get to the club, the boys are already playing. They're wearing capes and they fight with swords. Each team has their own cave where they can seek refuge. One of the caves is behind the bushes by the fence. The other cave has been built between two tall trees in the schoolyard. Kara loses her train of thought by her bike. She sees Lucas hiding behind the playhouse. The sun makes his sword glisten. Benjamin comes over to her. "Do you want to play?" he asks. "Yes, I would like that," Kara says happily. For one moment, it feels like she sees the schoolyard through different eyes. It seems as if everything is changed into an old-fashioned landscape. The clouds in the sky suddenly look like a big dragon about to belch fire. If she were playing, she would send an arrow directly into the heart of the dragon. "But I don't have a weapon," she says. "You can make one at the workshop. They have wood," Benjamin says, before he runs back to the cave by the bushes. "Kara," Julie shouts. She's hanging out of the window, waving a hairbrush around. Kara hurries inside. She throws her jacket and backpack into the closet and joins Julie. Julie is making a hair salon with chairs and mirrors. Kara doesn't really want to be inside. She cannot stop looking at the boys. It looks exciting. They're so caught up with fighting. Malou runs towards them. "Look at my weapon," she says happily, showing them a homemade knife made of tree branches. The handle is covered in grey tape. "I'm going to play war." "That is so cool." Kara is just about to explain that she wants to make a weapon too, but Julie interrupts her. "I cannot believe you want to play war, Malou," she sighs, and starts combing out Kara's hair.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.